Compared to FIR analysis in AFNI, using it in SPM is relatively easy. The preprocessing is the same as in the previous SPM tutorial on analyzing the flanker task. The only difference is in how the first level model is specified for each subject. What we're first going to do is copy this downloaded dataset that we downloaded in the previous tutorial into a directory called tone counting. Once that finishes copying, the first thing we're going to do is look at the timings for each subject and convert them using these scripts on the GitHub. Click on Convert Onset Times Tone Counting and either download it with the raw button or simply copy and paste it into a terminal provided you are within the tone counting directory and press enter. This will create two new text files, tone count run 1 and tone probe run 1, containing the onsets for each condition. Now, open a MATLAB terminal and open SPM fMRI. From the GUI, click on Specify First Level. We're not going to input all the data and the directory. We're simply going to see how to change the basis functions for a particular condition. So click on New Subject Session, click on Condition, New Condition. And then if we wanted to, say, load the onsets for the tone counting condition, change the name to tone counting, and then loading the onsets would involve things like using awk to extract the first column from the tone count onset times file. Once we print that, copy and paste it, just like you would for any other type of fMRI analysis. Now the main thing we're going to change here is go to basis functions and change it from canonical HRF to finite impulse response, and change the window length to 20 and the order to 10. You would then run this by clicking the green go button if everything else was filled in. However, we have a script that will run all of this for you, both the preprocessing and loading the onset times into a first level model. Go back to the GitHub page, go to SPM scripts, then click on tone count analysis script job and click on raw. Right click anywhere, click save as, and then save it to your tone counting directory, removing the .txt extension. Then you can go back to your MATLAB terminal and navigate to the tone counting directory. Run the script by typing tone count analysis script job and pressing enter. This will take about an hour to run for all the subjects. To view the results, click on the results button and select the spm.mat file within the directory sub01 first level. This will show the design matrix with 10 finite impulse response regressors per subject per condition. If we wanted to see where there was any event-related response to any of the time points that we estimated, we could calculate an F-test. In other words, conduct multiple t-tests, one per regressor, and see whether any one of them is significant. Click on the F contrast radio button and click on Define New Contrast. Give it the name tone counting underscore F-test. And in the contrast field, type I parentheses 10. This will create a diagonal of ones with one per time point for the tone counting condition. Click OK and then Done. Similar to the flanker analysis, set apply masking to none, the p-value adjustment to 0.001, and the extent threshold to 20. In the results window, click on Plot, Contrast Estimates, and 90% CI, confidence interval, and then select the tone counting F-test contrast. This will display a plot of the estimated activity at each time point in the time window you specified during the first level analysis setup. If you click and drag the red arrowhead in the glass pane window, you will see the plot update with new estimates at that particular voxel. For example, at the coordinates 0, 35, 41, the plot looks like this. Note how the overall pattern looks similar to the canonical HRF. There is a rise and a distinct peak around 3 to 4 TRs, corresponding to approximately 6 to 8 seconds after the onset of the stimulus, followed by a gradual decrease and undershoot. The pattern is not the same everywhere, however. Navigate around the brain and see the variety of profiles that have been estimated in this time window. Aside from an F-test, you may want to compare specific time points or combinations of time points against each other. Let's say we were interested in the average of TRs 3 to 4 compared to TR1, and where this difference was significant. Clicking on results again, select the same SPM.MAT file and define this contrast. Negative 1, 0, 0.5, 0.5. Since we are comparing two regressors against one, we will need to control for this number by weighting them by 0.5 each. This will create a series of contrast weights that looks like this. Now click OK, Done, and use the same correction settings as for the F-test. The resulting map will show where the average of TRs 3 and 4 are greater than TR1. In this results window, you could also click the Plot button and plot the confidence interval for the contrast of TRs 3 and 4 compared to 1. To see what's driving this effect, you could also plot the contrast intervals for the F-test. For example, in some voxels, TRs 3 and 4 are slightly negative, but at least they are more positive than TR number 1. Once you've done all of this, the group level analysis and ROI analysis will be the same as in the Flanker dataset. The interpretation will be different and slightly more complicated, but you will be able to make more nuanced claims about what is happening at specific points after the onset of the stimulus. Once you are satisfied with how to do this analysis, you can now learn how to do it in FSL, the last of the major software packages we will be covering.